Thank you everyone. May I request our guest of honor today, Dr. Arpit Dave, to say a few words. Welcome, sir.
ॐ आनन्दमयि चैतन्यमयि सत्यमयि परमे. नमस्कार. डॉक्टर शेठ, रिस्पेक्टेड हसमुख भाई, मिस्टर पब्लिशर, वेरी स्वीट एंकर, माई डियर फ्रेंड मेजर उन्मेश पंड्या, द की नॉट स्पीकर ऑफ दिस इवेंट ऑफ बुक रिलीज, लेडीज एंड जेंटलमैन, टू इम्पार्ट नॉलेज इज द प्राइम ऑब्जेक्ट ऑफ लाइफ एंड टू एक्वायर नॉलेज language is the tool. Remember, language is the tool, but a very essential tool through which a human being can impart knowledge, a human being can progress and go ahead. In that perspective, if we look at language, then language has a very important role in human life. Because in the process of evolution, only we people, means the human being, is having a gift of language. We communicate through language. Our communication is being done through language. In that perspective, I again tell you that language plays a very major role in our life. Now, when we come to the point that in any corner of the world, any race will try to adopt or to learn second language or another language, another than that of his or her mother tongue. When we start learning second language, there comes the problem sometimes. But if it comes through a very natural way, then it creates a magic. I am very happy to listen to from Dr. Sheth that these workbooks have been prepared not by any abstract theoretical ideas or theories only, but he has practiced all such words in his classroom teaching, in his experience. He has felt that this is to be added and this is to be deleted or not to be added. And this is a very unique thing, because normally when workbooks or books on grammar and language and language teaching have been written or published, they are based on some stock theories, tenses. In that way only we can put them. Articles, in that way only we put them. Part of speech, it should be there. but only essential things he has added. And why he felt that these are essential things? Because he has experienced in his classroom teaching, and that is very much important. Because language, language is in a flux. There are continuous addition and continuous deletion you will find in any language of the world. There is always a supplementarity in the language. When we write our question paper, our answer book, we need supplementaries. After 32 pages, we take one supplementary, two, second, third. Like in the same way, language has the characteristic of a language is supplementarity. We don't speak Shakespearean type of English. We don't speak the English in the time of Charles Lamb's. People used to speak. We speak a different kind of English. We don't speak English like Americans speak. We don't speak English like British speak. We don't speak English like Australians speak. We don't speak English like South Africans speak. We speak our own Indian English language. It is our right to speak our own language. And now we have adopted English. 62% of our administrative, commercial, and industrial activities are being done in English language. So we need English. Major Pandya will throw more light on it, because his topic of today's speech is past, present, and future of English. Future lies in English only, you know. Vedas have written thousands of years back in Sanskrit. It was the time when the knowledge was available in Sanskrit. This is the time. You see, if you look at the 19th and 20th century scientific inventions, you will find knowledge in English. If you want to have particular knowledge, either in science or in other fields like humanities or social science or spirituality or philosophy, you need to have a good command over English. And tomorrow there will be a new race. A new race is coming down. A new light is coming down from above. And that new race will be a race advanced than that of today's human being. We are transitional beings. We are not the final product of the of that particular energy or God or whatever we call. We are not the final product. We are transitional beings. But the next race which is coming, they will rise from us like we have been risen from ape or ape man. But that knowledge is available only in English. Yes, there are some mysteries hidden into Sanskrit. But that mysteries are being revealed by different interpretations and translations into English. So, future lies with us. Future lies with us. I personally congratulate Dr. Sheth on this very important event for this institution, event for him personally, and event for all of us. Because he has added something to the domain of knowledge. That is very important. See, ultimately, when somebody adds, why books are very important? Why this thing or that thing or this thing, they have also been manufactured. But they are not that much important. These are technologies and we need them. But the real magic of technology lies behind the science. And that science is available only in books. That science is available only in books. And when somebody writes a book, he adds a very important part into the domain of knowledge. For this work, it's a very difficult work. To sit and to write few pages is a very difficult process. Because you have to critically prepare your mind, you have to critically and analytically express them, that process into your writing, and that is very important, and for which I congratulate personally to Dr. Sheth, and I am very happy to be here with you all people, because you know, when we sit together, when we interact on a particular thing, we add something into us. I always feel, whenever I go to the classroom, I am completely blank. Yeah, I strongly feel that there is a dense darkness I feel on my forehead. I feel dense darkness here. But as soon as I enter into the classroom and as soon as I start teaching something, like a poem or a piece of prose or a criticism, and when I start speaking, new ideas comes. Like if you take one example of a story, that there is a story, a short story, like Anton Chekhov's story, which is a very short story, you will find. Oh, 1, 2 pages, 3 pages story. When you read it, you will feel that he is trying to tell these things. When you enter into the classroom and start speaking on it, I feel that no. It was his idea, yes, okay, but this is also a new perspective. And that is a new angle from which I would like to see. And this is the new dimension I find in this book. So such dimensions and angles and perspectives through which we pass only when we interact. So in that way, I feel very lucky and very fortunate to be here with you, like elderly people. Hasmukh Bhai and Dr. Sheth is a very senior and very experienced teacher who is not only teaching the students like you or me, but he is, taking training lectures at various platforms and at various industries. And it's very difficult to deal with the industry, because the management people are very smart, and they have always questions. They have always questions, and to deal with them, to satisfy them, and to improve something in them is a very laborious task. So I again congratulate him, and I feel very happy to be here. Thank you.